Okay, I've been asked how to get these cars in the Intermountain car auto racks here. Some of the guys are having issues with getting the cars to stay. This is a finished model. As you can see, I already got the cars put into this model. The best way I found to do this is a lot of people, if you bought these brand new, you might have noticed that a few of the doors might have been off. So if you get it shipped and the doors are off, just leave them off to the very end there. But basically what I do is I take off the roof to the auto rack, and then I basically just pull off the side panels. Basically just pull off the side panels here, and then I'll just do the top, and then I'll use my tweezers to get the ones in the bottom. And just pop the side panels back in, and they go in and they come out very easily here. So basically, to remove the side panels, all you basically have to do is I use my finger here to push in the middle. You push down and out, and they're pretty sturdy here. You just pull it straight on out. There you go. And to put it back in, basically the opposite direction, just slide them in. They have little grooves right there. So just slide them back in, and I push out and wing it back in. It's a little bit harder to do with one hand. And there you go. And I just kind of push the metal back, straighten the metal out. Because Intermountain did fix their issues with the side panels being warped out or warped in. So these are perfect. They look great. Again, very easy to do. Just be very careful. The roof, depending on when they were in production, what you're seeing here is the glue from the roof. So they do glue it down. Different production runs have different amount of glue that they use to hold it down. So some of the roofs were a little bit harder to take off than some of the other ones here, but this one was pretty easy. It popped off. It took a couple seconds. I did one this morning. It took about 10 minutes because I had to end up basically working the screwdriver in between here very delicately to separate the glue. That way I didn't hurt the roof there. So basically, once you get all the cars in, I put the side panels back on first, and then if you ever mess with these doors, they're kind of a pain. So then I'll get the side panels on here, put all these side panels back on, and then I'll work the doors back on. And pretty sure there's videos about that, but these are very delicate doors. The tracks are plastic, the doors are plastic. It's a very tight fit, so you just kind of work it top bottom, whatever you find works best for you. I get the door shut, and then I just take the roof and glue the roof back down, and then that's that'll be your finished product right here. And then that's kind of what it'll look like. And you can use I guess whatever cars you find fit, or trucks or SUVs you find fit for the HO scale. I actually found these off Amazon right here. These little cars. It was 50 of them for, I believe, like $12. Made by Eve Model. And I mean, they're light, they don't weigh next to nothing, and they fit perfectly. There we go. They fit perfectly for this model. I mean, they weigh next to nothing. I get five of them in there. Takes me a couple seconds. Throw a little glue on the wheels. And that is the one I use. So, feel free to comment, ask questions. I'll answer your questions as best I can. I hope this video helps. Okay, bye.